Selma Teacher 7, Mr. Barry here. Today we're going to be looking into a tool that allows us to find and create partitions within drives where you do not see the drive within Windows Explorer. Now I've been teaching a computer class for over 20 years, and in the past I've actually used this tool that I'm going to be showing you today. It's a free tool. It does have a free version, but it also has a pro version that has many more features. Now, we'll go over those two differences there here shortly, but just to let you know, the name of the tool is MiniTool, and what it allows you to do is manage your partitions, and this is the situation that happens in the, that has happened in the past. A student will buy a drive, bring it to class, and he'll set it up, and he'll hook it up to his laptop or to his computer, his desktop computer, and he goes into Windows, then he opens up Windows Explorer, as you see here, and he doesn't see the new drive. Now, one way to basically create this partition is to open up the MiniTool Partition app, and then go ahead and create the partition. I'll be showing you how to do that right now using MiniTool. Now, I'll be focusing on the differences between the free edition and the Pro Edition. For the free edition, it's basically just basic disk partition measurement tools. That's it. If you go with the Pro Edition, you get to migrate an operating system, you get to copy an operating system disk, you can copy the operating system partition, you can convert an operating system master boot record disk to a GPT disk, you can change the cluster size, you can recover lost partitions, you can perform data recovery, and you can even be using it in a commercial environment. For this demonstration, I'll be only using the basic free tools, and I'll have a link to it down in the description there. Hey, if you like these types of videos, please click on that thumbs up as it really helps the channel. Now let's go on to using the MiniTool. So as you can see, we do not see the new drive that I just inserted into the system. It'd be down here. And there's no new drive shown. So that's within the Windows Explorer. And what I've done is I've opened up the MiniTool Partition Wizard there. And right away, there it is. It is disk number 2. It's a 128 gig drive, 119.25 gigabyte usable. And as you can see here, it's unallocated. And one thing I want to mention right away is the graphical user interface that we see here. It's really well organized so that you can actually see each disk, disk 1, disk 2, disk 3, that are connected to the system. And it's easy to really navigate throughout this and find the tools that you need. What we're going to be doing is focusing here on disk number 2, the one that we just inserted, the brand new disk, and noticing it's saying unallocated space there. So what we're going to do is we're going to right click it and click on create. Now once you have create, you'll notice that it gives me the option to create a partition label. So I'll type this one security. So I'm calling it security because this will be going into my security cameras there. Next, it says create as primary drive letter, and we can change that. Let me call it drive letter H. And the file system, it can be the NTFS, or you can change it to any other that you want. Now, NTFS works best with the Windows 10 and above and all that, but in my camera that I'll be using it in, it expects it to be in the FAT32, so I'm going to change it to FAT32. By the way, just to let you know, that cannot be done to very large drives. So if it's a very large drive, you have to use the default there of NTFS. And we can notice here too, we can change the partition size. So let's say that you wanted just part of it to be for security and then another part of the drive to be part of the perhaps for all of your backup images. Well, you can go in here and go in and actually change this size. All right, and then create multiple partitions within each disk. But for right now, we're going to keep it to the max allowed for this drive, which is 119.25 gigabyte. All right, I'm going to click on OK. And now we're going to click on Apply. And click on Yes. And right away, I get this nag screen that comes up. And it says, put in a license code because you're using not the pro version. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put in a random code there. So I'm putting in a random code in here. I'm clicking on register. But right away it says this is not an active code. So I'm going to click on activate. And it says license is not, it's not invalid license there, because I just made one up. Click on OK. And I'm going to close that off. And it creates the partition anyway. All right. Now it says applied all of the pending changes successful. So even though I didn't have a valid license number, I just put in random numbers there. It applied and it created a disk. So let me click on OK and see what we have. So right now we have the drive letter G. It's a FAT32 and it is a drive. So let's go back to the Windows Explorer. And there's the drive right here. Drive letter G is now being able to be used. So let's click into it and see if it actually has something there. Okay, it says the folder is empty. Let's move a file into this drive here and just see if it actually works. So I get a picture of this bicycle here. I'll right click it and copy it. Now I'm back into the drive letter G there. That's the new drive. I'm going to right click and paste it in. As you can see there, it pasted in the picture of the bicycle into drive letter G, so it actually does work. So there you have it. MiniTool is basically a nice tool to have there to go ahead and create and manage your partitions on drives. Hey, if you like these types of videos, please give it a thumbs up. Comment down below if you have a comment or a question about either MiniTool, or if you have an idea for a future video, leave that down in the comments there. Really appreciate it. Thank you all for staying to the end. You all have a wonderful day. Bye-bye.